With so much of happiness and joy, I am here to present to you 9th Standard Prose 2. Just I would like to recall some of your experience in the past, namely your childhood experiences, the beautiful experience that you had, the unforgettable experience that you had in your childhood when you were around 10 years old. Imagine you lived in a house and your father is getting a transfer, or you have to sell a house, or you have to move to another house. Once you move away from the house, the old memories about the house still remains in your mind. The trees that they were in the house, and what kind of game that you had in the house with your friends. Everything is unforgettable in your life. It remains in within you. The same thing is going to happen in this beautiful prose. The title of the prose is, I can't climb the tree anymore. I can't climb the tree anymore. It's a prose for 9th standard. Now, before entering into the topic, I would like to ask certain questions towards you. Just to revisit your childhood memories, the lost childhood memories of yours. Yes, my dear students, read the first question. Have you ever tried swinging from a tree? I tried. Yes, I tried. I was successful when I was a child. But I know, what about you, my dear children? Have you tried jumping from one tree another tree? Swinging from one tree another tree? Yes, the second question. Have you ever climbed up a tree to pluck a fruit? Answer this question. Have you ever climbed a tree to pluck fruits? Yes, I did. I was succeeded. Really, I enjoyed those precious moments, the childhood memories. Those cannot come back again. So, let us go back to your life. Your childhood memories. Then only you are going to enjoy this beautiful prose. Now, I can't climb the tree anymore. This is the title of the prose. I can't climb the tree anymore. Once you read the title, it comes to your mind, why I cannot climb? Why I can't climb? Why he says I can't climb? There may be some physical weakness, or because of his age. You can take it because of his age. He can't climb the tree anymore. Or from some physical disabilities. Certain things, certain reason we can go on giving. I can't climb the tree anymore. Now, as we go inside the prose, we will see how, what are the various reasons he is going to put down for the title, I can't climb the tree anymore. Yes, my dear students, let us enter into the topic. This masterpiece was written by an Indian writer, an Indian author called Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond is the author of this beautiful lost memory, childhood memories of a man. This man was born on 19th May 1934. Still, this man is at his pink of health. Yes, he is very active even today. See how long he lived. He has done a lot of contribution towards English literature. And one of his interview with the reporter, he says, from the childhood onwards, I had a passion for writing. After completing his studies, his mother asked him, what are you going to do? Just tell me, what are you going to do? I want to become a writer. Hey, it looks so silly. Yes, I want to become a writer. Go and join the military. Let your career start somewhere. Go to military and join. This is advice given by his mother. But he was very determined to become a writer. That he proved. This is what happened. Still now he is writing. He is at the pink of his health. Yes, my dear student. He is born on 19th May 1934. He is an award-winning writer. The famous work of Ruskin Bond is The Blue The Blue Umbrella, a beautiful novel written by this great man. And this novel is made into Hindi film, and it has won Best National Award for Children's Film in 2007. In 2007, this novel was made into Hindi movie, and it received a National Award for Best Children's Movie. Yes, he has done a tremendous work for children, especially. All his writing somewhat refers to childhood memories. And those are the days where he used to write with pens or used to type with a typewriter. Today that thing is everything changed. Everything has changed. Now, as we enter into the topic, let us see how this man is going to recall, revisit, review his past childhood memories. The childhood memories, the lost childhood memories. He is going to enjoy being one with the nature now. Being one with the nature. The people say, there is no Wi-Fi in the forest, but we can be connected with various things there. There is a saying. See how people are one with nature. Once they move towards the forest or inside the forest, there they cannot have any communication with the friends, dear, near ones. But they can communicate with the nature. With the nature they can communicate. This is what happened to this great man. He is going to just recall his beautiful memories. That's what we will see in this lesson. See, as he's an old man, he's standing in front of the house. He's standing in front of the house because this is the house that where he used to live some 25 years ago. This is a house that belongs to his grandmother. As a middle-aged man, he stands in front of the house and looks at the beautiful house. He just recalls his past memories. There was a beautiful house. Next, fewer trees around the house. Then there was some gate. There's a gate as a mechanical gate. Next, we'll have these beautiful flowers, the entrance, and so it was so wonderful to see. But today, as he stands in front of the house, he could see only the beautiful house. Next, fewer trees here and there. The house is made of granites. Fewer trees here and there. Then there's a jackfruit tree. The jackfruit tree's branches touches the shadow of the tree falls on the house. That means a blessing comes from God. Even today, those who are living in the house, they are receiving blessing from God. This is what his grandmother used to tell. So he was very happy to see beautiful house, though things have changed because he is coming after 24 years. He was happy to see his grandmother's house. Next, what happens? He remembered his grandmother saying, a blessing rests on the house where the shadow of a tree falls. Yes, this is a tree, the branch of the tree that falls. The branch of the tree that falls on the house is getting blessing from God. This is what his grandmother used to say when he was a boy. Those sweet memories, just he is recalling. At the spot where he stood, there he had once been a turnstile. This is the turnstile. A mechanical gate. This is a mechanical gate. My dear students, the meaning for the term turnstile. This is a mechanical gate. See, this is what you used to have in the bank, especially when you enter inside the bank, only a single person can enter inside. Okay, wow. You have to push also slowly enter inside. This is the gate where once he had in their house, but today it is not found there. He used to play over them until unless he get greediness. He used to move around over this and used to play there, but today it is not there. He is feeling very sorry for this turnstile, which the gate is, which is not there. See, as he was just looking at the horse, a voice comes out. What do you want? A sweet voice comes out and is asking, what do you want? Who are you? Just tell me, who are you? What do you want? And this man just say, I am here just to have a glance at the house. And who asked the question? It is a 12 or 13 year old girl who had a black long hair, a beautiful eyes and she had. And that girl asked her, what do you want? Just I have come here to see the beautiful house. Yes. Are you interested to buy this house? No, no, not at all. Not at all. I am not at all interested to buy the house. I just come here to see this beautiful house. Okay. Whose house it is? It's my father's. See them. Girls replied to the man. Whose house it is? It's my father's. Normally, we Indians say, it is our house. But this girl says, it is my father's. It is my father's. Would you like to come inside and see? Would you like to come inside the house? With the pressure. Yes, I would like to come inside. But what about your parents? Won't they mind? No, no. I am allowed to take my friends inside my house. Do you think I am your friend? Yes. What's your age? I am just middle-aged. I am a middle-aged man. Okay, come inside. Instead of entering inside the house through the gate, this man wanted to prove himself that he is still young. He jumped over the wall. He tried to climb over the wall and he sat on the wall. He took a long breath heavily. And the girl asked, can I help you? Without any help, he jumped inside and he fell over the flowers. This is what happened while he is trying to enter inside the house, because the girl asked him to enter inside. And what about your family? Yes, my father is a colonel. He is supposed to become brigadier. Highest post in the army. My mom says he should have been a brigadier, but still he is a colonel in the army. Where are they? They have gone to the club. They will come back. By the time you enter inside, this is the permission given to me to take my friends inside the house. This is what happens. Now, as he enters inside the house, these are the beautiful, holy cocks, and he remembers his 24 years, the past childhood memories. He just recalls as he enters inside the house. See, he tried to climb over the wall, but unable to control himself, he took a long, a deep breath and fell down. This is what? Trespass. The meaning for the word trespass is a jump. Especially we see in the circus where people jump from one end to another end. And this is what happened. This man, he thinks that still he is very young. He wanted to jump, but his age does not permit him. As a result, he fell down. This is what this is. As they walked across the grass, he spotted a stone bench under a mango tree. Yes, there was a stone bench where he used to sit with his grandmother when he was a boy. His grandmother, after completing the work, namely pruning them, shaping the grass and so on, the rose flowers and so on, she needs a kind of refreshment, rest. She used to come and sit on the stone bench. This boy runs and towards her and sits beside her. And this is what the stone bench is here. This is a stone bench. And after pruning, the meaning pruning is a shaping. Shaping the plants, her grandmother used to take rest on the bench. What's the bench mean? Stone bench. This is what we'll see. A man closed his eyes and remembered all the times. Now, as he sits on the stone bench, he just recalls his past experience. He goes back to childhood memories. What happens? The music of the piano, he used to listen to the music of the piano while he sat beside his grandmother. Music of the piano, the chiming of your grandmother's clock. Chiming means what? A sweet chiming. The word chiming means sweet. The sweet sound of a grandmother's clock, plus a grandfather working here and there with a car. preparing something. These are the sounds he could recollect while sitting on the stone bench with his grandmother. Piano, this is a piano where you would hear a chiming, a beautiful melodious sound that comes from the piano, and you would hear the grandmother's chiming of the clock, grandfather's clock. This is what he could recall. The constant twitter of a budgie curs and on the veranda is grandfather cranking up the roll. This is a kind of bird. This looks like a parrot. Sometimes looks like a parrot. They used to come and sit on the veranda and they used to make a noise. Plus a grandfather working with the car. These are the sounds that you would hear even today as he sat on the same stone bench with the girl. The girl also sitting next to him. So the melodious sound of the piano, next the birds' noise, the noise of the birds, plus his grandfather working with a car. These are sounds you could hear on this day. The visitor's favorite place. Jackfruit tree. Halfway way along it, there was a small hollow in which he used to keep some of his treasures. He says, "This is the tree I liked so much. My favorite place is this jackfruit tree. See, because there I used to keep some of my precious things, treasures." See, he used to say, "Which some of his treasures. Jackfruit tree is his favorite one." So this was his favorite place. He used to play under the tree as well as climb over the tree and play with his friends. Those are the precious moments that which he cannot forget it. There was a hollow. This is the hollow. Okay, wow. This is a hollow there. This boy, as a boy, he used to keep something inside the hollow or the branches of the tree. What he used to keep? What are things he used to keep inside? As a boy, he kept something. That's why he asked permission from the girl. Okay, wow. I have cut something on the tree, on the hollow of the tree. And that girl asked, "Will you climb over the tree? Can you go and take and come?" I can't climb the tree anymore. This is the answer given by. Then the girl is asking permission. Shall I go and take and come? What are things? The treasures that you kept on the hollow of the tree. And now we will see a permission is granted. Yes. Marbles he had, these are the treasures that he kept on the hollow of the tree. What are things? First one, marbles he won. Whenever he had a kind of game with his competition with his friends, he won some of the marbles. Marbles he won, he kept there. Next, a book he wasn't supposed to read. The book he was no time or he is not at all interested to read. Those books he kept there. Next, a few old coins he had collected. Yes. These are the things which he kept on the hollow of the tree. My dear students, listen here. Marbles and books and old coin. These are the treasures, the precious things for this man as a young boy. He kept everything on the branches of the tree, the three things. Grandfather's iron cross. The last one is grandfather's iron cross. This is what you also got to see. Now, let us talk something about the cross. What is the cross? His grandfather was a military man, an army man. And during the World War, a German soldier gifted him for his bravery, a cross. This cross was gifted by a German soldier as for his bravery. And this cross was with his grandmother, grandfather. That only he took it and kept it on inside the hollow or in the hollow of the tree. So iron cross. Now remember, students, few things. What are things he kept on the in the treasure? As a treasure means the first one, some of the old coins, marbles, books, then the cross, the old cross. So these are the things which are kept safely in the hollow of the tree. Now, finding the same cross in the hollow apart from the jackfruit tree. Okay, well, now the girl climbed over the tree and she took away. I found it something. Yes, she took and came all those precious treasures, especially the books, the marbles ஓகேவா. நெக்ஸ்ட் த கிராஸ் எவர் திங் ஷு டுக் அண்ட் கேம் சி ஐ ஹவ் ஃபவுண்ட் இட் ஜஸ்ட் ஷீ ஹீ டுக் அவே ஃப்ரம் ஹர் ஹேண்ட் அண்ட் ஓப்பன் ஹிஸ் பாம் அண்ட் கெப்ட் இட் இஸ் இன்சைட் த கிராஸ் இன்சைட் த பாம் ஹீ கெப்ட் த கிராஸ் த கேர்ள் ஆஸ்ட் ஹிம் டு டேக் த கிராஸ் வித் ஹிம் பட் த மேன் செட் ஐ நாட் வாண்ட் ஐ நெவர் கேம் ஹியர் ஃபார் மை கிராஸ் I came here mainly to recollect, review my childhood memories. Because we left the house in a hurry. I was a boy. I was very happy to move away from the house. I was about to sail on the boat. That's why I forgot all these precious things that I kept in the tree. So, since you climbed over the tree, these precious things, especially the cross, belongs to take it. If you had not come, the girl is asking towards the man. The man says, you have been in the tree for another 24 years. For another 24 years, you will find the cross is the rust one. Okay, rusted one. And the man says, goodbye. Thanks. I come here. Okay, well, my visit was this old grandmother's house was mainly to recollect my past memories. My childhood memories, the beautiful memories, the unforgettable memories as I had in my childhood. Keep it with you. And the girl came along with him till the gate. The man just walked on the road. While there was a turn of the road, the man also turned and waved his hands to the girl, said, goodbye. And the girl went inside. Now, the old man, still you could get the mango-scented breeze in the summer season that touches his veins. There he felt, I cannot climb the tree anymore. I cannot climb the tree anymore. My dear students, what we learn from here, what we learn from this beautiful lesson called, I can't climb the tree anymore. A man goes on to his younger age, namely the childhood memories, revisiting his precious moments, the unforgettable moments, is something we cannot explain. Yes, my dear students, you will have an experience for yourself. There will be plenty of experience within you where it is something necessary to recollect some of the times that you spent with your fellow human beings, the times that you played with your friends when you were a child. Yes, Ruskin Bond has taught us a great lesson for us. Revisit your past memories. Review your childhood memories, the lost childhood memories that will give so much of energy for yourself. This is what I hope this lesson has given so much of energy for you to revisit your childhood memories. With this, we come to the conclusion. We go there. Next, I have attached here the study material for you. In this video, in the description box, you will find the study material and question bank as well as self-assessment test for 30 marks. Dear students, do it with great honor. Do it with great respect. Not just for namesake, but do it with full spirit. All the work that is given to you. Just to enjoy the lesson. When you read it, really you will feel that you are going back to your childhood memory. One with nature. Be one with nature. The colors, the sound are the wings of the nature. The colors, the sound are the wings of the nature. You may not get it again. So, my dear students, being one with nature is always good. Enjoying nature is always respectable. I hope my students enjoy this beautiful creation of God. We are blessed, we are privileged to be in the world once again. So, these are some of the study material, question bank I have kept for you. My dear students, the self-assessment test is this. With this, I come to the conclusion. I would like to ask the students to go back to childhood memories, experience the deep memories, the unforgettable time that you had when you were a child. Really, that will energize you. Really, that will boost your memory power. You will never forget in your life. Thank you.